faith community of St. Louis, Cahill. During our celebration, we will take time to be mindful of ourselves and each other during these difficult times. We ask God's blessing in our school, our new year pupils, our teachers, and the work that we will do together. We pray too for our parents and guardians, friends and families, and members of our community. We pray that our new year pupils will enjoy their learning and take delight in new discoveries. Help them to persevere in their studies and give them the desire to learn all things. May we all work together in a spirit of cooperation and respect so that each may become the person God wishes us to be.
And let us pray now that as we begin this new school year, we will have a real belief in ourselves, our gifts, and our abilities, so that the coming year will be fulfilling for each of us. So you just might like to bow your heads and pray for that intention. May we always be mindful of the needs of others and the importance of building our school community as a place of justice and belonging for all. Now I invite the pupils from Year 8 to present their candles. We ask you that our teachers will help us to keep the light of faith burning in our lives. Thank you. invite Olivia and Shay to come up and proclaim the word of God to us.
People were bringing children to Jesus to help him bless them. When the disciples saw this, they were angry with them for disturbing Jesus. But Jesus called the children to him and said, "Let the children come to me, and do not stop them, for the kingdom of God belongs to them. I tell you the truth, anyone who does not receive the kingdom of God like a child will never enter it."
Brothers and sisters, God loves you. He has chosen you as his own special people. So be gentle, kind, humble, meek, and patient. Put up with each other and forgive anyone who does you wrong, just as Christ has forgiven you. Love is more important than anything else. It is what ties everything completely together. The word of the Lord.
Amen.
Of your protection to all the students and staff that make our school community.
especially in these difficult times. Protect us and keep us safe always. Lord, hear us. Loving God, we have prayed for each other for the year of 2021, as we join together and grow in knowledge, friendship, empathy, and love, that we always feel the presence of God in our lives. Lord, hear us.
Loving God, we pray for our families and all those who help us and take care of us. Take care of them too. Please, Lord, hear us.
The center of the crest is the sword and the crown of thorns, Opposite the tower is fleur-de-lis, the emblem of the kings of France, representing the French origins of the Savoy order. On the lower left-hand side, there is a version of the coat of arms of Monaghan Town, where the sisters first settled in Ireland. The gold chain represents the bond that binds all members of the Savoy community together. The school motto, "Ut sit unum," means that we will become one, reminding us that we are all one and should place our hopes and dreams into the hands of our loving Father in Heaven, who is at hand for us.
Once again, I ask you to stand for the closing prayers. And in the second part of the prayer, you all join in that together. Loving God, we ask your blessing on these young people as they begin their lives as part of the St. Louis community. May they find friends who will walk beside them, opportunities that will challenge and fulfill them, and love and comfort them along the way. You're now presented with your Gideon Bible, which you'll use throughout your religious education in this school.
Thank you. Good afternoon, everyone. And a special welcome to Father Cahill. It is just so good to have a year 8 event like this. I think it's one of the first in a long, long time. So you're very special, and this is a very, very special afternoon. Now, on occasions like this, I usually take this opportunity to thank a few people, and I want to thank a number of people in terms of all of the preparation that they've put in here. Mrs. Morris, our head of RE, for the lovely liturgy and for coordinating the whole event, ably supported by Mrs. Fitzpatrick. I'd like to thank Ms. King as well, who has been the teacher in charge of junior school, and particularly of year 8, and overseeing everything that you need to settle in well into school. And of course, to Ms. Clark, your year head, who has years of experience, not too many years of experience, but years of experience guiding and supporting students through St. Louis, right from year 8 right to year 14. So you're a very, very lucky year group. You're also ably supported by your tutors, Ms. Smith and Mr. Fagan, Mrs. McVeigh, Miss Boyd, who again will guide and support you throughout this year and maybe in the years to come. I was really, really impressed with the music and the singing. Such a high standard, and you've only come together for a number of weeks. Fabulous, the talent here is outstanding, so I can't wait to see what it's going to be like in another couple of years when we do our next concert or show. So please encourage, if you're not a musician or a singer, please encourage and support those who do stand up in front of everybody and make that effort. They need a round of applause, I think, today. So congratulations. To join a choir, so, and particularly the boys too. Some of our most famous past pupils have been boys who have really embraced music and dancing and song and drama. So boys, be courageous, and other boys, support those people who want to do that, and please join in the music aspect of the school. I want to thank Mrs. McDonald and Miss Rennie for all of the dedication and patience and encouragement that the students have done. Now I'm looking around the hall here, and I had a sneak preview before lunch at the posters and the artwork and beautiful poems up here. They really are touching, and hopefully you'll be able to get those back into your classrooms or take them home with it to parents. So congratulations for that. They really are beautiful and very heartfelt sentiments included in those prayers. And I suppose prayers, that, you know, you can learn off prayers, okay? Prayers from the Gospel and prayers from your RE textbook. But I suppose the most important prayers are the ones from your heart, how you actually feel and how you talk to God, okay? And as we know from COVID, you don't necessarily have to go to Mass every Sunday to talk to God or to ask for God's help and support. So it's very, very important that you keep your faith strong and you ask God for help and support. You've also, you'll notice here on the table, there are lots of examples of image of products or items that reflect the diversity of the school and the wide variety of subjects you teach. I'm seeing a lovely stained glass window here, I assume was made in art, and I'm seeing a violin or a fiddle, and I'm seeing the earth there to represent geography, and the candle, passport candle there for RE. I'm seeing the camogie stick and the hurling bat, and the football for sport and extracurricular, and the technology project, and the castle, and so on and so on. And you can't expect to be the best at every subject, and you know, not many of us are, but as it says in the readings, you are unique, you are special, and you have talents and skills And don't for one minute think that you're any less or not as good as the person sitting beside you or somebody else in a different class. We all have talents and skills, and one thing that St. Louis does is to make sure that every student gets an opportunity to use their talents and skills. Okay? We can't all be teachers, we can't all be doctors or dentists. We need a whole variety of people coming from St. Louis and other schools. And the most important thing that you can learn in St. Louis is how well to behave, have respect for one another, respect difference, because that is one thing about St. Louis that we celebrate, is the difference that each individual has. God made us all uniquely. And never to look down on anybody or criticize anybody for who they are. So that's so, so important. Please remember that. Okay? It's so, so important that you respect each person for who you are. And as I have said many times, I don't expect you to be the captain of the football team or the rugby team. I don't expect you to take the lead in the school show. Okay? It's brilliant if people have talent. And usually we find those people who are very talented are very modest. They're not big-headed. Okay? They're usually hard-working and dedicated. So, everybody has something to offer, and don't for one minute think that you haven't got something to offer, because you have. Okay? Now, you've got your Gideon Bibles, and take it some time this evening when you go home. They're usually kept at home, or you can carry them in your book, in your school bag. You put your name in the front, and there's a wee section at the front that directs you to various readings in times of worry or concern or somebody's ill. Take a wee bit of time to look through that. And in normal circumstances, we have two volunteers who would come in and give them out. And they've been coming to the school for many, many years. One of those gentlemen was called Melvin Carter, and unfortunately he passed away over the summer. And I didn't realise that he had passed away until I came back to school, and the other gentleman that came in informed me that obviously they're not allowed to come in and hand them personally to you, but he mentioned that Melvin had passed away. So I just wrote a note last week to his wife, just sending my condolences. And she sent me a card yesterday, and I just want to read a wee bit from the card. This is a gentleman who has spent many, many years going around schools, giving up his own free time. I think he worked for years in Walter Watson's. Anybody from that direction? It's a company who makes steel. I think he was the managing director or the chief executive officer. So a very busy man with a very important job. But he took time to go around the schools to give out the Gideon Bible. And his wife sent me this wee note, but the writing is extremely, extremely small. So she goes on to say, the Gideon ministry was very dear to Melvin's heart. To get the word of God into the hands of boys and girls was so important. I know Melvin always looked forward to his yearly visits to St. Louis. The welcome he received always touched him. He would come home full of his time spent fellow worshipping with you over a cup of tea. And as you said, his work would live on through these little Gideon testaments. Melvin always prayed that the students would read them and that they would find help in their time of need through the help in the front, that is in the front of the Bibles, and discover that God loves them unconditionally. Thank you for your kind words of sympathy on the home call of my dear Melvin. And that was yours sincerely, Beatrice, that's his wife. So, there is a man that did something voluntary, and I certainly know that I have my Gideon Bible that I got in first year when I was at school. So I think it's very precious and very important, and hopefully you will find something in your life that you can help and volunteer others. So I want to thank you all for your participation, for the lovely singing, the music and the readings, and we'll finish off there. So thank you very much.